Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see series solution of differential equation. The differential equation with constant coefficient can be solved easily in terms of known function using different methods. But same methods may not applicable on the differential equation with variable coefficient. So here I am going to discuss the series solution for differential equation with variable coefficients. Before going to series solution, we have one definition for ordinary point and singular point. Let us see these two definitions, then we move on series solution. The differential equation P0x d2y by dx square plus p1x dy by dx plus p2x y equal to 0. So this is the homogeneous second order differential equation with variable coefficients. So first we make in the standard form in which the coefficient of double derivative should be 1. So we can divide by p0, so we can have d2y by dx square plus p1x by p0x dy by dx plus p2x by p0x y equal to 0. Now let us assume this is the capital P and this is the capital Q. So your differential equation in the standard form will be d2y by dx square plus p of x dy by dx plus q of x y equal to 0. So this is the standard form of differential equation and the coefficient of double derivative is 1 here. So for any given differential equation, first we try to make in the standard form. Now we'll see what is the ordinary point. A point x equal to x0 is called ordinary point, if this limit p of x tends to 0 and limit q of x tends to 0, both limit exist. So the limit of p and limit of q at x equal to x0 exist, so we say ordinary point, otherwise singular point.
It means if out of these two, if any limit fails to exist, so we say singular point. Now in the singular point, we have two classification. One is the regular singular point and one is the irregular singular point. So this is your regular singular point and second one irregular singular point. So if the limit x minus x0 into p limit x tends to x0, this limit and limit x minus x0 whole square q of x tends to x0, if these two limit exist, so the point is called regular singular point, otherwise it is called the irregular singular point. It means out of these two limit any one fails to exist, so the point is called irregular singular point. Now let us see the example of ordinary point and singular point. let us have one differential equation y double dash plus 2x y dash plus y equal to 0. So if you see this differential equation, this equation already in the standard form, so your capital P equal to 2 of x and q equal to 1, and the point is given x equal to 0. So it's very obvious P and q are defined at x equal to 0, and limit also exists. P limit will be 0, this q is always 1. So here the point x equal to 0 is called ordinary point. X equal to 0 is called ordinary point. Now let us have another example. X 1 minus x whole square y double dash plus 1 plus 3x y dash minus y equal to 0. Now first we make in the standard form, so that will be y double dash plus 1 plus 3x divided by x 1 minus x whole square y dash minus 1 upon x 1 minus x whole square y equal to 0. So your capital P will be 1 plus 3x by x 1 minus x square, and capital Q will be minus 1 upon x 1 minus x square. So this is your P and Q for the given differential equation, and here point is given x equal to 0 and 1. So let us see one by one. So first we take the x equal to 0. So at x equal to 0, P and Q are not defined because P is infinity and Q also infinity. So x equal to 0 is not ordinary point. So this singular point. So x equal to 0 is singular point because P and Q are not defined. Singular point. Now let us check whether it is regular singular point or irregular singular point. So that the definition we have x minus x 0 into P. So x 0 equal to 0 here. So xp we can have. So xp equal to 1 plus 3x divided by 1 minus x square. So limit x tends to 0. So this limit exists. This limit equal to 1. So xp limit exists. Let us check the other limit, x square q. So x square q will be minus x by 1 minus x whole square, and limit x tends to 0. So this is the 0. So xp and x square q both limit exist. So x equal to 0 is the regular singular point. X equal to 0 is regular singular point. So x equal to 0 is the regular singular point. Now what about x equal to 1? So let us have the x equal to 1. So x equal to also a singular point because P and Q both are not defined at x equal to 1. So what about the x equal to 0? We can have singular point. X equal to 0, the singular point. Now let us check whether this is the regular or irregular singular point. So x minus 1 into P. So this limit will be minus 1 plus 3x divided by x 1 minus x whole 1 minus x, limit x tends to 1, and x square q x minus 1 whole square q equal to minus 1 by x, limit x tends to 1. So here x minus p, this limit does not exist, and this limit exists. So this limit does not exist. So we say x equal to 1 is the irregular singular point. Even though the second limit exists, but if any one limit does not exist, so we say the irregular singular point. So we can have x equal to 1 is irregular singular point. irregular singular point. Now let us take one problem for the series solution. So the question is 1 minus x square y double dash minus x y dash plus 4y equal to 0, and the point is given x equal to 0. So the question is, find the series solution of given differential equation about the point x equal to 0. So first we have to check whether the given point is either ordinary point or singular point. So here we can write in the standard form y double dash minus x minus 1 minus x square y dash plus 4 by 1 minus x square y equal to 0. So here p will be minus x upon 1 minus x square, and q will be 4 by 1 minus x square. Now this p and q both are defined at x equal to 0, limit exists. So we say x equal to 0 is ordinary point. So let us take the series solution about the ordinary point. So your series solution y equal to summation an x minus x0 power n, where n vary from 0 to infinity. So this is the series solution form of differential equation about ordinary point. X0 is the ordinary point here. So here x0 equal to 0, so we have y equal to summation n from 0 to infinity a n x power n, where a n are unknown coefficient. So we'll differentiate, we'll get the y double dash, and substitute this y double dash in the main equation, and we try to get the coefficient a n by comparing the coefficient method. So what is the y dash here? So y dash will be summation a n n x power n minus 1, and here n vary from 1 to infinity because this series start with the a 1. I'll show you here y equal to a 0 plus a 1 x plus a 2 x square ... So your y dash will be a 1 plus 2 a 2 x ... So this y dash series start from the a 1, so n start from 1 to infinity, and y double dash equal to a n minus 1 x power n minus 2, and n vary from 2 to infinity because here y dash will be, you can see y dash will be 2 a 2 plus ... So this y double dash series will start from a 2, so n start from 2 to infinity. Now we have this y double dash, we substitute in the main equation, and you try to see what is the value of a n. So this is the differential equation. So here we have the four terms. One term is the y double dash, minus second term is x square y double dash, third term is x y dash plus 4y equal to 0. So y double dash equal to a n n n minus 1 x power n minus 2. So let us write the y double dash here. So this will be the summation n from 2 to infinity a n n n minus 1 x power n minus 2, and second term multiply by x square to y double dash. So this is our y double dash. If you multiply by x square, so this power will be n. So second term will be minus summation n start from 2 to infinity and a n n n minus 1 and x power n. And second term, third term we have minus x y dash. So in the y dash, the power is, you can see y dash power is x power n minus 1. So if you multiply by x, So this power will be x power n. So an n x power n. So here is y dash. So minus summation n start from 1 to infinity and an n x power n plus 4y. So y we know n vary from 0 to infinity, an x power n equal to 0. So this is your differential equation. After substituting this y dash and y double dash, let us see how to manipulate the power of x and the summation sign. Now if you see carefully, so here we have x power n, here we have x power n, and third also x power n is there, only here we have x power n minus 2. So for make it uniform, let us make x power n here also, there we can compare the coefficient. So how to make x power n? So n replaced by n plus 2. So this summation sign will be n vary from 0 to infinity. So this series, and I am going to modify only the first term and remaining term will be same. So first term will be summation n equal to 0 to infinity an n n minus 1. No, we are going to replace n by n plus 2. So this will be summation n from 0 to infinity and a n plus 2 n plus 2, and this is the n plus 1 and x power n. So I have replaced n by n plus 2 in the first term and remaining term will be same. So second term is the summation n start from 2 to infinity an n minus 1 x power n, and third term we have minus n equal to 1 to infinity an n x power n plus 4 summation n from 0 to infinity an x power n equal to 0. Now we got the power of x is n uniform. Now one more thing, if you see the n in the first term, n start from 0, second term n start from 2, third term n start from 1, and fourth term n start from 0. So for make it uniform, let us have n start from 2 to infinity for each term. So this term will open for n equal to 0, n equal to 1, then write the summation sign. This term also will open for n equal to 1, then write some summation sign from n from 2, and this term also will open for n equal to 0, n equal to 1, then we can write summation which vary from 2 to infinity. So the first term n equal to 0, so we get n equal to 0 means, so the next step will be n equal to 0, so we get a2 and 2 into 1, 2a2 will get n equal to 1 and x power 0, that is 1, n equal to 1, so you get plus a3, n equal to 1 means 3 to 6, 6a3 x plus summation n vary from 2 to infinity an plus 2 n plus 2 n plus 1 x power n. So this is your first term, fine, this is your first term. And second term I am not going to disturb because already start from n start from 2 to infinity, so nothing to change here. So it will be n minus 1 x power n. Now third term will have the two terms, one n equal to 1 if you open, so it will be a1 and minus n start from a1 and n start from 2 to infinity an n x power n. And the fourth term is start from 0, so it will be 4a0 plus 4a1x plus 4 summation n from 2 to infinity a n x power n equal to 0. Now if you see, now each term start from 2 to infinity and power x power n. So by combining all these four terms, we can have the recurrence relation by in an plus 2 and an. So first term we have an plus 2 and remaining three terms we have the an. So we can get the recurrence relation. Before recurrence relation, let us have the constant term. So constant term we have 2a2 plus 4 0. So we can write here, we'll compare the constant term. So right hand side everything is 0. So the right side constant term is 0. So left hand side constant term is 2a2 plus 4a0 equal to 0. So a2 equal to minus 2a0. A2 equal to minus 2a0. Now if you see the coefficient of x, so we have 6a3 plus 4a1 and right hand side it is 0. So by comparing the coefficient of x, we have 6a3 plus 4a1 equal to 0. 6a3 plus 4a1 and one more a1 we have here. So this will be minus a1 equal to 0. So this is the 6a3 plus 3a1 equal to 0. So a3 equal to minus a1 by 2. So a3 equal to minus a1 by 2. So a2 we got in term of a0, a3 we got in term of a1. Now let us club this all four terms and 1 2 3 4. So this club all four terms and try to get the recurrence relation. So we can have by comparing the coefficient of x power n both side, so we get the recurrence relation. So this is the x power n, so we can have recurrence relation n plus 2 n plus 1 a n plus 2, and if you take the a n, so this will be minus n square plus n minus n plus 4 equal to 0. So if you simplify, a n plus 2 equal to n minus 2 by n plus 1 a n. So this is the recurrence relation. And already we have a2 equal to minus a0 and a3 we have minus a1 by 2. So let us start try to get a4. A4 equal to n equal to 2. So we get a4 equal to 0. So if a4 equal to 0, so a6 also 0 and a8 also equal to 0. So the even term will be 0. Let us have this odd terms. So a5, so for a5 we will have n equal to 3. So a5 equal to, so 3 minus 2 1 by 3, 1 by 4 a3, and a3 we have minus a1 by 8. So this will be minus a1 by 8. So a5 equal to minus a1 by 8. a6 equal to 0. Let us have one more term, a7. So for a7 n equal to 5, so 5 minus 2 3 divided by 5 plus 1 6 and a5. So this will be 1 by 2 a5. So a5 equal to minus a1 by 8. So minus a1 by 16. Minus a1 by 16. Then we got this all a0, a1, a2, a3, a4. So let us write the series solution. I'll write here y equal to summation a n x power n. So this will be a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus a3x cube a4x4 plus a5x5 plus dot dot dot. So a0 plus a1x and a2 equal to minus 2a0 x square and a3 equal to minus a1 by 2 x cube plus a4 is 0, a5 is minus a1 by 8 x power 5 minus dot dot dot. So we can have the y equal to a0 if you take common, so 1 minus 2x square, and if you take the a1, so we can have x minus x cube by 2 x power 5 by 8 minus dot dot dot. So this is your series solution of the given differential equation where a0, a1 are arbitrary constant. Since the differential equation was the second order, so we have two arbitrary constant in the solution. So this is your series solution of given differential equation. Thank you.